The IIFL Wealth International Chess Tournament at Mumbai, Mount Litera School International. The event is the biggest ever prize money tournament for juniors players under 13 years of age. And the man behind the show, the one who has supported it, is none other than Mr. Karan Bhagat of IIFLW Mumbai. We are fortunate to have him in studio today with his wife, Mrs. Shilpa Bhagat. And well, for starters, sir, is your chess as good as your finances?
No, not at all. I think I hardly played chess as a child, and I don't think Sushilpa also played much of chess. But it's obviously got a lot of similarities, both chess and finance. Both have a lot of unknown variables, and at the same time, you need to know a lot about it. So the domain knowledge has to be very strong, but you still have to have the ability to react differently at different points in time. So I think it's not comparable, but both require a fairly good understanding of what you're getting into, plus a very strong resolve to continue to do well.
And how were you actually introduced to chess?
So introduction to chess was by chance. I think we had a lot of coaches coming in to the building where we stay for different kinds of sports. And one coach also came in for chess, and both my twins, Kush and Kyra, were deciding to play which sports, and my son got on to chess and he showed some initial talent. And the coach suggested we start getting to play some local tournaments from a fairly young age of 4, and we decided to give it a chance. And since then he's been playing for the last 2 years, and we've got into the sport both competitively and to a small extent professionally also over the last 2 years. And we both had the opportunity to travel to different places with him while he's playing a different set of tournaments.
Do you see yourself identifying with the sport in one way or the other? I mean, how does this change from a parent to sponsoring big events? How did this come into effect?
Actually, a parent and a sponsor are very different roles and responsibilities. So as a parent, obviously, I'm attracted to the game board because of my son. As a sponsor, I think two aspects. One, I think if you look at the infrastructure of the sport itself, I think it requires a lot to be done. And relative to any other sport, I think a relatively smaller amount of money can make a substantial amount of difference to the infrastructure of the sport. Today, if you look at many other sports today, the quantum of money required for sponsorships will be substantially more different in terms of scale. And second, I think from a junior perspective, from a children's perspective, the sport is very interesting because it allows us to reach a variety of parents very early in life. And I think chess is looked at as a knowledge game for the right reasons. And all parents want the kids to play either casually or for fun or seriously at different points in time, because they think there's some exposure which would come out of the game and the children will become more tough. So I think it's a good way for us as a sponsor also to be able to access a large variety of parents across cities, especially Bombay, Delhi, Bangalore, for purposes of our business also through a very quick medium, which in some ways is representative of the kind of business we do, which is driven both by knowledge, rigor, and a lot of preparedness, which is something which is required in chess also.
Yeah, okay. Coming back to the economics in chess, I mean, what sort of module do you think would change this world? Because we are looking at, like, this is the first of its, we have said it over and over again that this is by far the best organized event in the country. And well, we have Vishwanathan Anand became a grandmaster back in 1987. Right. So we are talking about almost 28 years later that we're still looking at, you know, a better event, a good event, a world class event for children.
I think it's a combination of a lot of things. I think it's I think sports in general, barring cricket, requires a lot of public private partnership. Okay, so it's not going to be driven only by private partnership. In some ways, only if there's a in some ways the partnership today or the driver of the sport is only the government. And if we can form some kind of public-private partnership where the government with its reach and expertise and licenses can come in, and the private sector can come in with either soft infrastructure or hard money, and we can combine both, then these sports will kind of do well. But more importantly, I think we need to catch the more inclined kids towards chess slightly early. And I think therefore, if you know, for the few international tournaments I've been to, for example, we went to Asian Youth when we took Kush to under 5. And the kind of preparation which countries like Korea, China, Mongolia came with in terms of their coaches, there were two coaches traveling. In terms of, you know, the parents were not there for even under 5 kids. Only the coaches were there. They were wearing Mongolia jackets. There was a sense of already representing the country. And from an India perspective, it was very, very different. Korea had a contingent of 18 or 20 kids, and all the kids were sponsored by the Korean Federation, purely because Korea decided to kind of push chess as a sport, and they were running training camps in schools for the last 2 years, and out of that group they took the brightest 18, 20 and got them to the school. And there it was very tough. When we asked them, is it an easy thing or tough thing to do, they said it's very tough because most of the chess professionals do not know how to teach in Japanese and Korean. So it's very difficult for them to find coaches to come down and actually teach them. But in spite of that, they're making a tremendous effort to kind of get it done. In India, we obviously have a big language advantage because we have a great number of players and most of our good coaches would know English and Hindi both. And most regional languages where the kids can kind of get associated with. So I'm not sure what would change it. Nothing will change it in a year. This event won't change anything as such. Even though it's organized extremely well. But at a larger scale, I think only if we can get some more infrastructure and a professional sponsorship available to kids at a young age, only then we can see the number of GMs go up, and potentially that will improve the economics of the sport at some point in time, and then it will have a kind of a trickle effect.
Are you looking at identifying such children and probably supporting them in the future?
We can. It's a good idea. I think we're looking at how to get associated with the sport deeper. So that is one of the ideas we've heard about. Yeah, it's not something we are against, so it's something we should definitely look at. So I think the team will be working on seeing how to kind of take this partnership forward, both in terms of especially on the junior side on one side, schools on the other, international events on the third side, and then kind of seeing how we can nurture specific kids. So I think all four are on the anvil. How we go about doing it is a different thing altogether.
Obviously, it will require another strategy, planning and everything.
Absolutely.
Else in place.
Absolutely.
And also we realize chess has now become a rich person's sport. It's not like a poor man's sport anymore in terms of the amount of travel that you have to do in order to pursue different tournaments and also different, the coaching, everything is expensive. So I think a talented kid should not be able to pursue the sport just because they lack funds.
I think chess is still can be pursued by the common man very easily because all you require is a board and 32 pieces? Yeah, 32 pieces to play, right? So it's quite easily pursuable by everybody. But at the same point of time, as soon as you become more and more competitive, the kind of financial aid you need becomes more and more.
There's a lot of travel.
There is, from a parent's side, a lot of sacrifices involved versus what you're doing in life currently, from a career perspective and so on and so forth. Like we heard, Shahzul's dad, who was a doctor, had to give up his practice half time to kind of spend more time with him. So I think all put together, it requires a large investment, both of time, effort, as well as possibly money in different formats. So I think all put together, the sport can do with some bit of money to begin with. But as happens with a lot of other things, only if we identify kids early and they become successful, will the sport kind of really catch on in terms of... otherwise, I think if we can somehow make it a little more audience-driven, a little more friendly in terms of... it's a tough thing because it's a slow game. cerebral sport, yeah. It's a tough thing, but if you can somehow create the excitement around it or the infrastructure around it, you know, it might, for example, Formula One's also a very boring sport, right? You just sit there and keep looking at cars running around. Once in 65 laps, you'll have an accident and you'll get excited. It's an extremely, extremely boring sport, but you still have 30,000 people paying $1,000 to see the cars whizzing past, right? But at the end of the day, I keep coming for it repeatedly. There's a lot of excitement around it. There's a fair, there's a lot of things around it. So we have to think of unique ideas of how to possibly, while the seriousness of the game continues, the ability of people around the game to also enjoy the game broadens a little more, because only then people will get more and more interested.
You were mentioning the sacrifices that the parents might have to make. How's it like being a chess mom?
Honestly, this game has taught me a different level of parenting. I thought parenting was easy until I got introduced to chess. It requires a lot of emotional control, because you know, you feel helpless at some point in time because the child is playing and you're just waiting outside and you're just praying that the child wins for his own benefit. And if he doesn't, you go through a set of emotions which are very difficult to deal with. So I think this sport has made me stronger as a parent. I can deal with my failures, with life seems much easier compared to chess sometimes. So the journey has been extremely enriching, fulfilling, and it has given me a lot of strength. And I think I see my child learning life skills through this sport. So as a mother, I feel I have introduced him to a sport which is helping him build his foundation to live a better life, and not just a sport, like his ability to focus, his ability to, you know, strategize, his ability to deal with failures, decision making. All of these are larger aspects of life which one needs. You know, we all struggle, we all strive to sort of get these right in our life. So I think this sport is teaching him a lot, and through him I'm learning a lot. So not the technical aspects of the game, but more, you know, softer issues which are actually more important, I feel.
I would like to add, I think generally speaking, chess moms need a lot of credit, because I think it's been extremely difficult job to do. And not only chess moms, even I see a lot of dads spending a lot of time with the kids. I'm not as good as a lot of the dads who are spending time, but I think there are a lot of good chess dads there also. I think what we tend to ignore, and possibly me and Shilpa are very lucky in that sense. We are in the in a place where we really don't need to worry about sacrificing some more small parts of the or our careers in terms of spending time on chess. But even as far as Shilpa is concerned, our ability to go back to a corporate life, even after the kids have become six, which is possibly, given the fact that they go to school at 8 and come back at 4, one of the big reasons of not going back to corporate life is the fact that, you know, you practically need to travel once in 2 weeks or twice in a month. And therefore, it keeps your life very unstructured. And therefore, in some ways, does not allow you to go back to a job. For us, obviously, that decision is easy, because she doesn't necessarily need to do it from a financial standpoint. But if you exclude people like us and start enlarging the entire pool, and then you suddenly start seeing the challenges of so many other chess moms, where families will be possibly required for both parents to kind of go and work. And to manage that together, to manage all the travel, manage the coaching and stuff like that. So it requires an innate amount of sacrifice. I think we can't undermine it at all. And I think whenever we've been out to travel, I think we've seen some of the parents really put in a majestic effort to kind of try and get the kids there.
We've been hearing a lot of heartrending stories over the years. Like, I've been into this chess for over 30 years now, and every time it's a new story, obviously. Now moving on, another question to you is, You apparently you have played a very crucial role in putting this event possible. This is what the feedback is, and how did this come about? Like,
you know, I honestly think I've done very little to put this event together. I would give a lot of credit to Praful sir, because it was his dream and he sort of made it possible. So I think the credit goes to the man who dreams and eventually puts in a lot of effort and ensures that it sort of works out. But when we were in Taiwan, and you know, when you travel internationally for these tournaments and you see the kind of support the country, be it the government, be it the public, be it, you know, the private sector, whoever, they are making it possible for their own country kids and for so many others. So when Professor said that, you know, we would need some kind of an aid, so I was very hell-bent that, you know, this should work out, because, you know, we have the ability, a lot of us have the ability, it's just the inclination that is required. And a small effort from our side can, you know, it's just a ripple, it has the ripple effect. If you take that one little step, it can actually touch so many other people's, you know, other kids' life, interest, their whole journey can become so much smoother. Because we have gone through, you know, we've gone through times, you know, in terms of infrastructure within India, which we never thought we would be able to go to. Simple things like using an Indian washroom. Honestly, we are Indians and I'm proud of it, but somehow we've never used Indian washroom. It was really hard to use those toilets, you know, stand in the sun for so long. We've gone through all of that so that, you know, the child can pursue this. If it can become comfortable for the child and the parent, and this journey is smoother, and a little amount of effort can make it possible, then why not? So, yeah, that was the whole idea.
Sure. One last question to both of you. Where do we move from here? The IFL World International Chess Tournament?
No, so I think, as I said, I think we kind of break it down into 4 or 5 parts. We definitely want to be associated with the sport for the longer term. So we've not done it as one single standalone tournament. Between us, I think Mount Litra and Mr. Zaveri, we said that if this tournament is going to be a success, which it looks like, we'll kind of try and at least commit to this tournament for the next 5 years. But as I said, this is a small part of the story. I think if you can get some bit of school penetration, some bit of sponsorship for Bright Kids, and an overall kind of co-partner for the sport over the longer term, it'll make a lot of sense for us. So that's where we go from here. And otherwise, we continue to enjoy the game.
That's well. I think we put it all together very well, and amen is all I would say now. And let's see how we can pull this all through in the next 5 years. Hopefully, we'll have a bigger and better event. Really, really honored to have you both here.
Thanks a lot.
In the studio, and thank you.
Thanks.